Hi, it's Andy.
Hi, it's Dave.
Hi, it's Kirk.
Welcome to the A.D.K. Rock and Metal channel, and today we're going to be checking out a band called Sorcerer.
Yes.
Right, well, okay, Andy's nodding, Kirk's
long-term
nodding.
Right, fan, long-time fan of Sorcerer.
Because I'm completely oblivious. However, I did pick this with Andy in mind, so... Because we don't cover a lot of Doom on this channel, so I figured we should do a little bit more Doom from time to time. Because we like to see Andy smiling. He doesn't smile enough, the miserable git.
he only smiles when he's listening to miserable music.
Is it about death, destruction, and make you want to kill your wrist? Yes, I love it! Right, we're checking out a song called The Dark Tower of the Sorcerer. Anyone know this track?
Yeah.
Andy?
It's on an album called Sign of the Inverted Cross, I think. Is that where it's taken from? It's not on their most recent releases, I don't think.
Okay, well, you can go last on your feedback then on that one, because you know a little bit more about this than I do, and I will definitely be going first on feedback. We're going to watch the video and then obviously feedback at the end. Let's go check it out. We'll be right back. Okay, there we go. Sorcerer and the Dark Tower of the Sorcerer. Okay, I'm going to kick this one off. Do you know what it reminded made me think of, especially vocally? Because obviously you're talking classic rock, classic metal. When I talk about classic, I'm talking about like the Judas Priest vocal, like Rob Halford style. Great vocalist. It just made me think of like, was this like a Judas Priest song where they put it on a 45 single and they put it on 33? They went, oh, that'll make a good song. Because it just sounds like a slowed down Judas Priest track. But all seriousness, it's put down really, really well. Because I guess experience-wise, okay, yes, you've got My Dying Bride, who do clean vocals, but you tend to think of a lot with me with Doom, like bands like Paradise Lost, because that's where I don't know enough about bands like Candlemass and stuff, so Cathedral, and to know the vocal styles, with it, how much clean there is. But I'm finding there seems to be quite a lot of clean vocal deliveries in Doom. And I thought he did a great job on it. Good hooky riffs. Doom songs seem to like to repeat the riffs quite a lot before they like to do changes. So it seems to be long passages, but they seem to work. They seem to be a good length. Visually, video-wise, yeah, it was good. They did what they could. They've taken some nice dramatic early dawn sunset scenes and kind of cut themselves and transparencies and worked well. I'm not too keen on that kind of fake fireplace flame effect that they've got going on at points in the video. I was like, I don't quite get that. Doesn't tell anything about the Dark Tower of the Sorcerer with some fake flame thing on the front of it. Didn't need it. The video looked good anyway. But from a song, it's actually something I probably would check out again because I quite enjoyed. I liked where he went vocally because he had a great pair of pipes on him. So yeah, enjoyed that. Kirk?
In terms of a doom metal song, I would compare that with Trouble, that Chicago band, and their 1991 album. I think it's called Eric Wagner, who died 2 years ago. Similar vocal range. Quick history lesson for our viewers. What are the differences between doom metal, sludge, and post-metal? And we can clearly work it out in that video. Traditional heavy metal vocals, more theatrical, a bit like Manowar. So really strong, like tenor-type vocals, aren't they? Also, shredding guitar solo, you don't get that in sludge metal or post metal. They're a lot noisier and messier and have more of a punk influence, even though they're playing at slow tempos. So I think it's important to recognize, I would say this is doom metal with that background in traditional heavy metal, certainly in the lyrics. Sometimes you don't know if they're tongue in cheek or not. You've got a lot of cliches there in the lyrics, which is quite amusing, to be honest, but you could basically just write those lyrics and make them up, couldn't you, about blood moons and you know, the wizard of the night and various things like that. So I find that quite amusing. I'm not too sure if the band do though, so I don't really know what more to say on that. The guitar tone is excellent. I love that vibrato at the beginning. Do you know what it actually did remind me of? Black Sabbath, when they recruited Tony Martin. You know that song, Rise Up Into the Shining, had a similar vibe to that. I love that song. So
I'm Andy, No Matter It Rains, looking for a new vocalist, mate. Go on, get in there.
Wish that, do it again.
Rise Up Into the Shining.
You're in.
But yeah, Dave, I'm with you. I could listen to that all day. It's fun. It gets you going. It's just air guitar heaven for me, listening to music like that. So even though I don't take it too seriously, I do enjoy that type of doom metal that has its roots in traditional heavy metal. Andy, give us the lowdown.
Okay, yeah, this is Sorcerer, a band that I am a fan of. And we're going back to the late 80s. Must have been an advert in Kerrang because I wrote to the band. They're from Sweden and I purchased their cassette tape called Anno 1503 and it was absolutely brilliant. You know, this is when I'm getting into doom, and you made the comparisons to Trouble. I would say, you know, they're heavily influenced by Candlemass, early Candlemass. You know, to me, it's traditional doom, which does have that clean, powerful, high, you know, wide range vocal delivery, which Anders Enberg delivers. This particular album comes sort of, where I'll do the math, but 25 years after that demo, you know, this is their sort of first proper album release. They I think they must have had a hiatus in that time, and sort of reformed sort of in sort of the early 2010s, and released this album, which with this track's come from the album Shadow of the Inverted Cross. And yeah, Kirk, the lyrics aren't, you know, Pulitzer Prize winning vocabulary. It's quite standard sort of sword and sorcery, heavy, you know, fantasy heavy metal lyrics. But that suits the music. I absolutely love it. Wasn't a great fan of the video. The sunset and sunrise shots that you see were almost replicating the two demos that they released in the late 80s, early 90s, the covers of that, which I thought was a nice touch. But like you, Dave, the flames at the front would be more suited to like a sort of black metal band. Didn't really go with this type of band or this type of song. But yeah, I like the way Anders repeats the verse chorus, but then steps up a level with the pitch and the delivery. I really like that. That's sort of one of his trademarks, really. But yeah, that's sort of like the lead song, that, you know, the main song from that album, and certainly my favourite. And this has made me sort of perhaps check out their more recent releases, which I have not come across for whatever reason. But those early demos, Anno 1503 and The Inquisition, absolutely fantastic traditional doom with very heavy Candlemass influences, and I urge anybody who's a fan to go and check those out, and obviously this album and subsequent Sorcerer albums. But that was brilliant. Thank you very much, Dave. Really, really enjoyed that. Would like a bit more to take from the video, but it's a great song.
There we go. Sorcerer and the Dark Tower of the Sorcerer. Now, if you enjoyed our video today, please do like, share and subscribe. And we will see you on another video sometime very soon. Take care.